Hello, I'm Clayton Birch, State Superintendent of Schools. And this week's Keeping Connected, we want to take a little look at mental health, the resources in our schools to support our children each and every day. We recently celebrated World Mental Health Day. What a chance to step back and take a look at exactly all of the support our schools offer to make sure our students are supported both socially, emotionally, and with their mental health. We know that students and staff throughout this pandemic have been stressed. Their schedules have been off kilter, they've been in and out of school, and as the pandemic continues, that stress continues. We want to make sure that our schools continue to play that vital support for each and every one of our students, but also for each and every staff member. If we allow these issues to go unaddressed, they become debilitating. They are a distraction and will continue to grow and fester, impacting children's overall health and development, as well as their academic achievement. Today, we talked to Susan Jones, counselor at Ripley Middle School in Jackson County. Ms. Jones is a 2021 National Certified School Counselor. She's also the 2020 West Virginia Middle School Counselor of the Year. She shares the importance that not only her, but the school plays each and every day in the children's lives. Additionally, we're going to meet some students on this week's Keeping Connected, natural student helpers at Ripley Middle, selected individuals to be trained to recognize social-emotional issues with their peers and how to assist. Ripley Middle has put in place an important practice of nurturing students. Ms. Jones absolutely represents that one caring adult. Let's take a look at their story.
Jackson County Schools is so blessed from the top all the way down to me with supports. Our superintendent, our board office administrators support what we do. Our teachers are trained to watch for changes in their students, to get to know their kids, to build a relationship first that is so important with their academic learning. And then let us know if there's something that we might need to look into to help that child. Here at Ripley Middle, we have two full-time counselors. My co-counselor is the best in the world. We also have a community and school site coordinator and a social worker. We have a school psychologist that are all wonderful. The students themselves are trained. We have a group called Natural Helpers that are chosen by the student body as being students that they trust and would go to if they had a personal problem. We train those 55 students on how to watch for changes among their peers, how to be very aware of social media posts or comments. The student that's sitting alone, the student that might be sharing something with a friend that they overhear that could be a concern, they're trained to help with minor conflicts. They're helped. They're trained to be a helper to others. They're also trained to watch out for those that might be alone and to be a friend. But then they're also trained to come report to us if some of our students don't have the courage to do that themselves. So the social emotional support, the mental well-being of our students, we think is very, very important.
I think students feel less threatened by like kids my age than they would say a counselor. So if kids would normally come and talk to me, and we're voted into this, so if they trust you, then they would put your name on the ballot. So kids would feel comfortable to come and talk to that person, and there's almost a natural helper in every classroom. So if a student has somebody to talk to and they know they can feel comfortable, I think a lot of times they'd feel more comfortable talking to a student than they would a counselor.
When we had COVID and being home and maybe their home lights were not the best, I definitely think having somebody that you can feel safe with is awesome to have, because you want to have someone that you can feel safe to talk to and talk about if you have a bad home life, or talk about somebody who has affected you negatively during a pandemic. And it can help your grades, it can help depression, help mental health, just like being at school. Even at school, you need to have resources to talk to, even if you have mental health issues.
I feel like it's really important that we can go and talk to our POs, because we feel more comfortable with POs normally than we do when we're talking around adults, because the POs may have or are going through the exact same thing.
They know we're in the Natural Helpers. They know Ms. Jones wouldn't elected us for no reason.
They know that we're trustworthy, and they know that we can come to them so that we feel like we can lean on them. And I know I personally will feel more comfortable coming to a student at first. Unless we can't handle it, then it would be more something that Ms. Jones and one of our counselors or adults would handle.
During COVID, a lot of people weren't able to see some of their family members and other friends. So being able to talk to somebody, I think, really helped out with that.
I don't think that anyone has been hit harder by the pandemic than our children. And looking back on my 31-year tenure in counseling and seeing the changes that have happened over the years, and now knowing that children's mental health is the very foundation of their educational learning, just having this opportunity to speak on behalf of the importance of our kids' social and emotional health and how that is so foundational to their academic learning, to their success later in life. The more we make everyone aware of it, I think the more that we can become accepting and understanding of mental health needs, much the same as we are our physical health. Thank you.